Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of the Venom Vlog, and we're continuing our Venom Versus series with a battle that happened in a book called Darkhawk. And now this was like a fun little early 90s comic book. I kind of like the premise a little bit. It's about this kid named Chris Powell who finds this like magical stone in a way. It's like a diamond from space, and it grants him these powers, and it releases this like energy, this dark energy in him. And he kind of, you know, siphons it, you know, throughout his body, gives him super strength, things like that. But he also can shoot this beam and everything. It was a kind of a neat concept. I didn't read too much about the character. I think I read like the first couple issues, and then he showed up in maybe like Secret Defenders or a couple of those books, like team up books every now and again. But then of course I read these issues, which I was able to track down on Mile High Comics back when I got that last pile of books, like probably like 6 months ago or so. And I was able to pick these up, and it's a two-part story. Well, actually it's a six-part story, but Venom shows up for two parts of it. Where basically Darkhawk comes across the island that Venom found himself on. Like him and Spider-Man fought like in the Amazing Spider-Man around after issue 330 or whatever it was, or 315, somewhere between there, when they were out on the island, and he thought, you know, Venom thought he killed Spider-Man, and then he decided to stay on the island. That's what's happening here. Obviously, we know Peter Parker got away. He took like a boat. He got off the island and made Venom think that he was dead. He left those bones there with scraps of the Spider-Man costume on it. And Venom was like, all right, I killed Spider-Man. I succeeded. Kind of like Thanos after he snaps his fingers. He's like, all right, I'm just going to like sit and enjoy the sunset now. And that's what Venom does. And he stays on this island for a short period of time. And during that, there was a lot of fans going, what's Venom up to? Like, what's he doing over there? And so Danny Fingeroth, who wrote these two issues, and Mike Manley, who did the artwork, they were like, hey, let's explore that. Let's tie that into this story that we're telling. Because in the Heart of the Hawk six-part storyline, which ran from like issues like 10 up to like 15 or something like that of Darkhawk, basically what happened in it was Darkhawk's crystal that's on his chest gets ripped out by Tombstone, a Spider-Man villain, and then once Tombstone gets it, he's like taking it to like mystics and scientists, and he's trying to get them to figure out how it works. So while that storyline's going on, Chris now basically is powerless. I mean, he still can release the beams, but it causes a great amount of pain in his chest, because basically, kind of like Iron Man style, there's Iron Man like there's this hole in his chest, and this crystal, you know, preserved all that energy inside of him. And now that the crystal's been ripped off and someone's manipulating it, it's causing him, you know, moments of pain and discomfort, but it's also, you know, causing that energy to leak out in some ways, and it's hurting him that way too. So he's like got his chest bandaged up. He's trying so hard to keep the energy within. Of course, there's a couple times in a comic where he has to release the energy to, you know, blast off a bad guy to kind of keep himself safe. But obviously that just hurts him more. So it's causing him more pain. So it's kind of a neat story arc, and especially so early on in this character's career that something like this would happen to him. So I thought Danny Fingeroth did a really good job, you know, telling the story in the Darkhawk book, but then also getting to this point with Venom and finding a nice organic way to fit Venom into the story, which was, you know, basically Chris, you know, his mom is working this case against this guy named Bazin, who is like this crime lord who made a deal with Chris's father and kind of got him in over his head. And so, and there's like dirty cops and there's all these things going on. And Chris's mother, she's trying to crack the case. And she has three sons, you know, I think it's Chris, and he has two younger brothers he has. And one of them, there was like a bomb rigged to a car that was supposed to blow up and kill, you know, Chris's mother, you know, because she's an attorney, and she's trying to basically, you know, indict Bazin, and she's trying to put him in jail forever. And so of course he's hiring people to go hurt her, and Tombstone and these other people, he's like trying to get them all involved to go hurt her. But then Tombstone goes off in his own story where he, you know, gets the crystal, and he's like, all right, I want to figure out how this works to get more power so I don't have to work for people like Bazin anymore. So he's kind of got off doing his own thing. And then meanwhile we have, you know, Chris powerless, trying to figure out what's going on, trying to find his father because his father has been kidnapped by these bad guys and taken to an island. There's like this guy named Felipe who has taken him to this island, and coincidentally that island is near where Venom is hiding out. And so Darkhawk doesn't know this at the time. So as he's trying to track down where his father is, he's coming up with all these clues and figuring it out and learning that his father is on this island, this remote island out in the middle of nowhere. And so he goes on that journey while his mom stays behind, and she's working on her case, and she's getting in way over her head. And this guy named Fred, he's like a cop who worked with her husband, again, dirty cops and everything. She gets kidnapped by him, and he's like, what are you doing here? And she's like, look, I can keep a secret. I'm not after you guys. You know, whatever you're working on, I'm just trying to get the guy who's after my husband and who's trying to ruin my family's life and who put this car bomb bomb in my car, and it didn't even blow up on me. It blew up with one of my younger sons, and luckily Darkhawk showed up to save my son. But, you know, my son is still in the hospital in a coma, and he's still, you know, fighting for his life. And she's like, so I want the piece of crap that did this to me. And so, you know, you kind of see her in the situation of, is she going to fall into the gray area? Is she going to blur her morals just to get the guy she's after? So it's kind of neat. I mean, I thought it was a really good story the way they balance it all out. I actually don't know how this ends because part six I don't have of this storyline. I just have up to part five, which is, you know, the main stuff that we're going to talk about here today, which is Darkhawk versus Venom himself. And this is not like a team up story. It's not like your typical these two fight and then they team up. It's nothing like that at all. They do fight. There is a cool twist at the end to explain maybe why Venom doesn't win per se, because that's kind of what the thing was. Like, they wanted Venom, anytime he appeared in other books, they didn't want him to, like, be taken down too easily. They wanted it to be, you know, they wanted to keep the character interesting, but also, like, a fan favorite, and they didn't want him to lose too much, which I'm kind of against in some way. You got to have him lose a little bit, but they come up with interesting ways, at least the writers do. They come up with interesting ways to have their hero of their book, like Darkhawk, win, but still not, like, sully the, you know, the kind of the reputation of Venom in a way. And I thought the way they did it here was kind of interesting. I, you know, I don't know if I'm fully on board with it, so I'll tell you guys what it is, and then you guys can tell me your thoughts down below. But like I said, you know, Darkhawk shows up on the island, and it's coincidentally the island that Venom's on. And so he has to deal with Venom now. And at first, it's kind of cool, because Darkhawk's like, dude, I don't know anything about you. I don't know who you are. I don't know what's going on. I don't know why you're here. I don't care. I'm just here to find this, like, drug guy, you know, who's after my father and my family. And Venom's like, you know, yeah, but if you go back to the mainland, you're going to tell everybody where I am. And I just want to be here. I killed Spider-Man. And now I just want to rest and you know, relax here. And Darkhawk's like, killed Spider-Man? He's like, what are you talking about? Like, I saw Spider-Man like a week ago. He doesn't say this to Venom. He's like, I'm going to keep my mouth shut because I don't know when he thinks he killed Spider-Man, but I'm going to try to learn more information. He goes, but clearly this guy is crazy because I don't think Spider-Man's dead. I saw him on the news like just the other day. So when they're fighting, you know, Venom is cutting, you know, he's like not even holding back. He's just going nuts all over Darkhawk. And he's like, I don't want you to reveal to the world that I'm still alive or that I'm here because I got what I wanted. And now I'm just kind of enjoying life on this island. And Darkhawk's like, dude, I don't care about any of that. Like, we don't even need to be fighting. Like, we could, you know, you could help me find this criminal guy. And Venom's not even listening. I guess he's so caught up in this, you know, privacy thing and the fact that he won. He's just like, I don't want any, whatever you're saying, I'm not listening, dude. So they get into a full-on fight and they go crazy all over each other. And like I said, Darkhawk doesn't even have his full extent of his powers. And even in the middle of the battle, he's you know, dropping down in pain because, you know, Tombstone is off trying to get the stone, you know, working through mystics and scientists. So they're manipulating, you know, the stone. And every time they, you know, do something to it, Darkhawk reacts and he falls down. So he's starting to get the one up on some of these battles against Venom, but then he drops down and he like can't breathe for a few minutes and, or, you know, for a few moments, and Venom gets the upper hand again. So it's a really tough battle, and Chris is fighting with all his heart, and which I really liked when I remember even rereading this, but reading it the first time, I was like, wow, this guy has a lot of heart. Like, he does not give up. It reminded me a lot of like Dick Grayson, where I was like, this guy, he loses some fights, you know, but he always he's standing at the end of it. And, you know, no matter what, like, you can punch his face in, but he'll still stand there and he'll be like, I'm not going to fall, you know? And that's kind of what Chris comes across as. And I was like, wow, what a pretty cool character. And then, like, again, I said, his younger brother is in the hospital. And his other younger brother is kind of watching over him. And he's like, where's Chris? Where's my mom? The mom, obviously, like I said, has been kidnapped. She's talking to those dirty cops. And meanwhile, their father is on this island with this bad guy here, this Felipe guy. And they're going at it. And then that's when Felipe says, look, I covered you for Boz and I covered you for everything that's going on. I'm tired of this. You know some things that we need to know. So I brought you to this island, make everyone think that you're either dead or, you know, or that you've been kidnapped. And I'm going to get my answers from you here. So tell me what's going on. And Mike's like, you know, Chris's father is like, look, I'm not going to tell you. You know, there's safety things in line. If something happens to me, you can threaten to kill me all you want. But if something happens to me, my family is going to be okay. They're taken care of. They're going to be protected and they get all the money that, you know, I'm hiding from you guys. So go ahead, kill me, do whatever you want. But I know my family's taken care of. And so this Felipe guy is like not having it. So he finally loses it and starts attacking Mike and is, you know, puts a gun right to his head and is ready to kill him. And then meanwhile, on another part of the island, you have Darkhawk here finding out that Venom is afraid of fire and that fire hurts him. So he picks up these two sticks from the wreckage of the plane that crashed and he brings them around trying to fight Venom. But then again, his heart starts acting up, and the energy in his chest starts acting up because these mystics that Tombstone has are manipulating the blade, you know, the stone once again. So it's really tough. It's a really tough battle for Darkhawk, but he does get the upper hand. He starts fighting Venom. He's going crazy all over him, and then Venom, as Venom, you know, gets the upper hand once again, because this battle just goes back and forth. It's a really good tennis match between these two. But then Venom gets the upper hand, and as his tendrils go around, they start feeling the hole in his chest, and it senses something. The symbiote can respond to something, because this stone and the energy it left behind is from space, and the symbiote kind of reacts to it, and it can sense something about it. And it's like, you know what? There's something going on here about this guy. I'm going to ease up on him. And then as Venom starts easing up, Darkhawk, you know, lets his wings loose, the claws cut through, and he takes down Venom, and he just starts beating the crap out of Venom and knocks him down, knocks him out once and for all. And then when he leans over him, it looks like Venom is dead. And he leans down and he even sees there's no heartbeat. And he's like, whoa, I killed him? He's like, I've never killed anyone before. He's like, this is, you know, even though he's threatened because his family's in danger, his, you know, his own life's in danger. He was interrogating bad guys to get to this island. He threatened to kill a couple guys, actually. So Darkhawk was willing to go over that edge. He was willing to kill if he needed to, especially to protect his family. And so so in this one, he was like, wow, I threatened to kill people, but I've never done it. And now I've killed whatever this Venom thing is. And he's like, so I'm just, you know, I don't know what to do. So he's kind of wandering away. He finds this compass, the compass on the ship, which is going to lead to where his father is, because it's like some kind of amulet compass thing that will like be a tracking device that'll lead to his dad. So he finds like a little boat. And then he actually leaves the island and goes off and goes around to another, I guess, another part of the island, because he went in a big circle because there's like, you know, some weird things going on down in this island near the Caribbean. I don't know if there's like some magic going on or something, but anytime you try to leave, you kind of circle right back. So which also maybe kind of explains why Venom hasn't left yet too. But anyway, Venom even says, he's like, yeah, I faked my death, kind of like I did with that guy in the vault in Amazing Spider-Man issue 330, where I played dead, and then I was able to like get out and escape the vault. He's like, so that's what I did here, and I tricked Darkhawk, but the reason I did was because I sensed that he wasn't innocent, that he was someone who's just trying to do something right for his family, and that there is you know, goodness in him, only goodness in him. And so that's why Venom decided to back off. And then he said, plus, if he thinks he killed me and he's a good person, he won't tell people he killed me. He won't tell people my location. So I'm just kind of banking on this guy just leaving and never coming back and never telling people I'm here. So of course we know what happens to Venom. He eventually gets off the island, finds out Spider-Man's alive because Spider-Man comes to the island and reveals himself. And that brings, you know, Venom back, you know, to fight Carnage and all these other things. So it's pretty neat. So yeah, you get this little adventure, this side adventure of Venom on this island. And then meanwhile, Darkhawk, he goes, you know, back, he gets to the other side of the island where Felipe is, where he's threatening his dad, Mike, and they get into a big tussle. And unfortunately in the battle, you know, Mike, you know, Darkhawk's father, he dies. He gets shot by Felipe. And then this other character, something stone, bloodstone or something like that, Lodestone, I think is the character's name. She shows up to fight Darkhawk, but Darkhawk gets the one up on her, takes her down. And then when Felipe aims a gun at Darkhawk to kill him, that's when Mike steps up and kills Felipe and shoots him right in the back. So unfortunately, you know, Felipe's down, Lodestone's been defeated, Darkhawk is running out of energy, and his father is dying in his arms, and that's where this issue ends, is his father saying, look, I noticed that you've protected my family a couple times, you have some kind of connection to them, I don't know who you are, but please promise me you'll protect my family, and Darkhawk says, I promise, I will, and then, you know, Mike, you know, dies, and Chris is like, no, you know, this is my dad, you know, so there's like a nice, you know, or not a nice, but just like a heartbreaking moment at the end there. But it's like the art's really great. Like the art's nice. Mike Manley did a really good job on this. And Danny Fingeroth, like I said, did a really good job adding a lot of emotion to this character and this story so early on. I mean, you know, 14 issues into this book, or you know, and it's really solid stuff. And like I said, I'm sorry I don't know the ending of the story for you Darkhawk fans, but if you know it, let me know down below, because I don't think I picked up issue 15 ever. I rebought these ones just, you know, so I could have them for Venom, but I read, I think, the whole first like 13 or 14 books of this, but I remember when I was a kid, I stopped reading after this. I didn't pick up the next part. So if you know it, definitely let me know down below. Because at the end of this book, it has, you know, his brother's life is hanging in the balance, his mom's life's hanging in the balance, and he's stranded on some island, and he passes out and is, you know, almost dead, right at the tide where the water's coming in. So, he, you know, I guess he could choke or drown or something. We know he doesn't, because there is a rematch between Darkhawk and Venom that we'll talk about in another episode. We'll do a part two to this, because I think that's these issues here, which is 35, 36, and 37, and it's called Rematch with Venom. And these aren't part of like a greater story. These are literally just a rematch with Venom. The Bloody Return of Venom, the rematch with Venom, and then you have this last issue here, 37, where they their final battle. So we're gonna get into that in a future episode, probably not, you know, in the next week or so, but we'll get to it because the next episode I want to talk about is Wolverine and Venom versus Nightmare, which is going to be a really cool episode. So hopefully you guys stay subscribed so you don't miss out on that. But if you have any thoughts on this Darkhawk story, this two-parter, let me know what it is down below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. If you read it, if you haven't read it, whatever it is, let me know down below and we'll continue our conversation down there. Thanks so much for watching my show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you in the future. Peace.